Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me.
Relationship. On a really good day, is effortless, and it just, you're on top of the world. But on a bad day, you just kind of feel like quitting. But there's one thing about it, it's like you never quit. You invest in it. And sometimes you pay people to help you out, and sometimes you talk to friends, and sometimes you just go practice, practice, practice. And then it turns around. And, you know, I've spoken to Chris about this on many occasions. With golf, I believe there's three things that you need to do to continue golfing over the years. You have to have a really good sense of humor, and be very patient, and you also have to have a good sense of humility and not expect everything to be perfect. And that kind of sums up our relationship. But what I wanted to say is, you'll sort of notice there's a bit of a somewhere over the rainbow theme. You haven't picked up now. This is the time. and there's a reason for that. Chris, was the one who said to me, it's a song about possibility. And that means a lot to us. 7 years ago, when I met Chris, Lily was 16, Fiona was 9, John had just turned 5, and Hannah had just turned 3. And at that time, possibility for us in the relationship department was not tremendously hopeful. We bring a lot of experience, whatever you want to call it, with us. And there was probably a really healthy skepticism and fear about being in a long-term committed relationship. And I never had imagined in a million years that 7 years later we'd be sitting here getting married. And what I want to say about Chris is how much I have admired him. Because possibility for us really meant letting go of a lot of our sort of behaviors that we had that we put up to sort of protect ourselves and didn't bring forth the best in relationship. And Chris has always been so open about doing that, and it hasn't been easy, and it's been difficult. And you've always been open, and you've always done that. And I think there's two reasons. One, you're doing it for yourself, but two, because of the love you have for him. So I want to thank you for that. And Chris said something to me, probably about year 3 or 4, kind of when you realize that, there's some things, the way that we're wired, that don't necessarily serve you well. And he said, I just want to be the best Chris I can be. And I want to be the best dad, the best stepdad, the best partner. And that's what I want. And yeah, I'll tell him that later. Space just to be you, and for you to just be your true self. And so now we're in this great space where things are steady and they're comfortable, and it's kind of really kind of fun. So I'm just really looking forward to spending the rest of my life with you. I love you and I respect you. And I love all these kids. They're a bonus. Well, not every day, but most of the time.
Stressful times, and believe me, for anyone else. Like all relationships, we had our share of good times and bad times. But it's during those bad times that you're always there wanting to stick your foot in the door and open up those lines of communication. We're so much stronger now because of the determination. I've used that analogy where, like, a bone that's been broken, it's just healed that much stronger. And I feel now that we're like a suit of armor. You know, we're so much stronger now. Like an armor.
That's the Florida analogy.
But we have weathered the storms and we have learned from our experiences, which has brought us to this day. And today, I pledge to share my life, to be welcome, and to respect you, and to acknowledge you, to love and cherish you all of us. So today is the day of the rest of our lives.
Wedlock, and have given and pledged their troth each to the other in the presence of this company, by the virtue of the authority vested in me under the laws of the state of Florida, I now pronounce you man and wife.
Yeah. start thinking about it and be nice. We all know Chris is gross, but so I think that's about it.
Oh, one last addition from Uncle Dave, and I agree. There are so many things to glass, you guys have to guess.
And you climbed the glass.
Oh, yeah.
So
that's gross.
We're too old for that.
No, you're not.
Go to your room, you plant it, it's yours. Go to your room.
And when
lights.
You should get your camera and screen.
Chris and Robin and the new and we can get along well and prosper in the years ahead. And it's been a pleasure for me to be here and have an excuse for the whole family to come to it, because we thought we'd be in the summertime, then here we are, except Janet, who is our daughter in Australia, and she has emailed wishing all of us here, the guests and everyone else, the family and the bride and the groom, the best of everything. And she's just eating herself up, you know, every day ahead, so it's all over for her. Regardless, I wanted to thank the special guest, because I don't think that's been taken care of. And I wanted to thank a lot of people here for being so good about telling us how they met and so on. So I cross that out.
Patrick, so enamored last Christmas.
off. So, but anyways, when I've known you guys now for 6-7 years, and from the day one, I said, oh my God, there's something different about this guy because you'll actually listen to him.
Apparently he was getting ready for that, but special.
And I'm very happy to be here, and I wish you all the best. So. dad first told me that I was going to be visiting the house of Robin, the owner of the lead, I was a bit scared because my dad had told me that there was going to be a 15-year-old and a 9-year-old staying with us. And when I heard of a 15-year-old, I was like, well, a teenager is probably going to have to be bald with tattoos.
Yeah.